this.
Yeah.
Kind of in like a sprinter position where his left leg is up like this. Okay? We're putting all of his weight onto his right leg to make his left leg light. And the way we're doing that is we're hitting with a pull push movement from our right side. We shoot our leg through and we raise our hips up. Okay? For now, we're going to assume that we already have this ankle. He's going to fight that later and we'll look at a trapping sequence. Okay? Now from here, our knees rainbow out to the right. They come up and over and down to the right. Now he's down on that side. We have control of this free leg. There's different things we can do with that right here. Okay? So we're entering with shin on shin and doing a single leg X sweep to the outside. Okay? Shin on shin. Establish that position. And sometimes, your rocking chair entry into something like that. You get in, you get to that angle, you get this bend in the knee. We make him step into our armpit as we shoot our hips up, keeping our double leg attack. Rainbow the knees out to the right. Get heavy on that top leg and we'll look at finishing later. Okay.
Okay, thank you, sir.
It's the same move we just did. Same move. Instead of him kneeling, he's standing. Okay. That knee out and an ankle turn. Same move. Does that make sense? Let's do that. Okay, good. One person, 4 minutes, please.
Okay. So, come in like so. Not much out of
Right at the knee, yeah. Now your right hand grabs the knee.
Yeah.
Hold right at the knee joint with your right hand.
Yeah.
Yes. Making the knee bend. That's right. Let's go ahead.
Okay.
Okay.
got your own hand, you got what? Your right hand grabs this knee, that ankle, all on your left side. Yeah, so you got to do it with your hand. Yeah.
Right, okay, yeah, I was doing it.
This is the push, this is the pull.
That's what I was forgetting.
Here you go. Now, so you want to do that low, you want to pull it in. So check this out. I don't want to be a test or a T. I want to be an X. Because look at how much more surface area. So here, now that we see this whole thing, the whole thing is in contact. Technically, because your knees on the outside. Got your knee? Yeah. This is what you're looking for. This. Through. So yes, see that? So if you have a fella down on the floor,
When we do our pummeling here, my goal in pummeling is to create that T. So look, I'm going to 90, pummel through, and that gets us around. If we do that forward, it creates a problem in our barrier, our guard. So what we're trying to do is keep this knee outside and this foot inside in this nice full contact point all the way from top to bottom. So when we get through to here, okay, we still have a little bit of control of that knee drop. Okay, if we go too far, that knee falls down. Okay, so that's a problem. So the earlier, we don't want to go too far, and what we want to do is kick our leg straight so that he falls. They don't really have much of a chance to put that knee down anyways. Okay, now this second knee is what stopped me from just sitting in the mount. This knee here, this left knee, keeps him disconnected. There's potential for sure that he can just beat us. Okay, so we're combining the moves smoothly together and not going too deep so that he can knee cut pass. We're here, keep your leg straight and wrap and block with that left knee. Okay, now our next piece. He's going to come down on all fours, his hands go to the floor. Really hard for me to keep him here. Another thing that he's going to do is he's going to use his right hand to peel this off. He's going to step that leg back and away. Okay? Now, if he takes his hands off the floor, we're okay here, but this, yes, so this is a real problem. But Jens is good. He will take his hands off the floor, but I don't have that leg. So here's what we're going to do next. This is the next piece. He peels our grip off. He stands back up. That leg's too far. We take your foot off. Here's the new move. We're countering the counter. He's peeled my grip off his far ankle. I can't get to it. We step back. So we take our heel off. We put our butterfly hook into his butt, making him step up this way. Hands on the floor. And then we reestablish our single leg X. And we swing our knees out a second time. Okay, so that'll be the end of what we're trying to work today. Okay, so let's look at that again. Shin on shin. Disengage your leg early enough that they're not dropping the knee. And you're taking their leg and you're putting it into your right armpit. Okay? So we get shin on shin. Don't go too deep with this. Kick this leg through. Drop that foot. We're here. He peels my hand off. Gets that leg away and he stands up. There's lots of stuff we can do from here. Lots of stuff we can do. We can back step and start attacking this leg, but here, I just want to go back and we're redoubling our attack. We're going back to home base. We take the foot off, left butterfly hook, makes him step up, bringing his rear leg back into play. Right heel comes back in, swings his knee back out, and we're really back where we were, okay? Reestablish your sweep off of his defense. Make sense? Okay. Last piece, guys. Good patience, good focus. Ready? Good. So, seated, kneeling, standing, counters. Stand up. Good, guys.
Yeah, you get it.
Yeah.
push.
Yes.
The words by my hands on the floor.
Right on the TV.
That's a real issue. Yeah. One that I've worked on for 12 months old about for the last few months. Just under 2 minutes left, guys. Two that are available to us right off the bat is if his right foot so is just a little further than I can grip, but he hasn't put all of his weight away from me onto that right leg, that right there. So his weight is still towards me, but his leg's far enough away, a little further, that I can't get to it with my hand. So what we have there is we have a back step option, where we'll keep his hands on the floor, my right leg back steps. I can kick this straight, and now we're into sal. And then there's a whole series of moves that we can do from here. We got the star leg, we can straight ankle lock, cross ankle lock, outside ankle lock, cross heel lock. We can go into an Aoki lock. We can do our sal, or our knee knock. There's lots of stuff we can do, and then we can start to adapt his bottom leg and drag us across. But that back step puts us into a whole other series, and it deals with the problem that I'm talking about when a guy puts his hands down on the floor. But here's the thing. Everybody knows that now, so let me steal you again. So here's what guys are doing. We'll go into shin on shin. I get in. He gets that hand, steps back, and now this time he puts his weight away. So now I can't back step. He's solid. He's just solid. Keep those hands on the floor. When his hands are on the floor, he's really hard to deal with. And just so you guys know, if you're ever in a situation, this is a really good option for you. Put your hands on the floor. Okay? We'll deal with how to go about getting out of this after, but we're looking at this bottom guy position for now. So, the next idea is when his hands are on the floor and he's put his weight away, is instead of using our right leg to make his far leg come to us, we do a matrix, so this is called, and we step down on this leg. Now we're in two.
You'll look for a saddle on the other side.
Okay, so there are answers, and there's solutions, but you keep running into a position. We work our way in, and you get to a spot where you do a sweep and it works great. Then all of a sudden, your training partner develops a counter and he's solid in that position. So this is a really good sequence that highlights that issue. Guy posts his hands, okay, well, if he shifts his hips away, we can go into that matrix hook. If he shifts his hips towards us, we can backstep in the saddle. If he just locks real, there's a knee bar right there too. So we'll keep looking at that. And I hope that continues off of where we were last time. That's kind of the goal. We didn't do our guillotine stuff, but we'll get back to that on Wednesday. The arm and guillotine, right? Cool. Okay, thanks guys. You got a fighter. Martin, we'll do some rolling if you got time. And that'll be that. There you go. Actually, let's line up, bow out. Anybody who doesn't want to roll doesn't have to. And we will call that class. And we're going to stick around roll and roll. Okay.
Good guy, that suits down a bit. I'll get you to switch over to here. Your belts, guys. Okay, down this end, please. Okay, there we go. Move down just a bit. Good guys. Thank you very much. Okay, if you can get it on this one, we'll bow and fire. Thank you. Very cool. Grab some water.
Thank you.
Thank you, Paul. Yeah. That was good.
Yeah.
So what I want you to do is I want you to
Thank you.
I started to slide up, and I was like, oh, I do want to slide up for what I'm trying to do, but I'm not in position to do it yet. So.
Really is.
Yeah.
So I always slow down. Spring, like fall, busy.
Equipment, the front team, and the parent.
Yeah. Well, that works, see?